Hi, it's Matt from the AutoHarp store. I'm going to fill you in on what makes these AutoHarps different and what makes it the right one for you. The first choice you're going to have to make is 15 chord or 21 chord. The 15 chord is generally used in music classes for a couple of primary reasons. One, the buttons are larger. Two, there's only 15 chords, so the music is easier to play. And three, the way the chord bar is constructed, it is sturdier and will stand up to the rigors of having inexperienced people playing it. The 21 chord is for the regular player of the AutoHarp. Anyone that is a musician or wants to be a musician that is going to try to learn new songs and develop their skills as an AutoHarp player. The next choice you have to make is acoustic, acoustic electric, or electric only. The acoustic AutoHarps are very popular, as bluegrass and choir music a lot of times lends very well to the acoustic sound. Acoustic electric is for anybody that wants to eventually hook up to an amp and play a louder sound, but also wants to have the option of playing acoustically without an amplifier. The pickup that is built into the acoustic electric and the electric AutoHarp is a passive pickup. Prior to 2013, they had an active pickup. An active pickup required a battery pack in the back of the AutoHarp and had a built-in equalizer on the side. They've decided to simplify everything and go with a passive pickup. A passive pickup requires no power. The equalizer is not built into the AutoHarp, so you have your choice of using whatever equalizer you want, and it transmits the sound to the amplifier. Once you've decided 15 chord, 21 chord, acoustic, acoustic electric, or electric, now it's down to appearance and sound of the woods. In terms of woods, spruce is your standard wood for musical instruments. It's been used for decades in guitars, and this is what's considered a musician's choice. There's other woods, like bird's eye maple and mahogany, that have really nice tones to it and really nice designs. I'm going to flip this one over. You can see the design work that's in this bird's eye maple. In general, all the woods are going to sound good. It's more about the appearance than it is the sound, although there is some slight sound differences. But as you saw with the bird's eye maple, some of them have really nice features to the wood patterns. Once you pick out a wood, another consideration you can make is, do you want a satin finish or a gloss finish? A gloss finish is going to provide more protection as it is a thicker coating. A satin finish is going to produce a little bit richer sound because it is a thinner coating and it really lets the wood resonate. One last choice you're going to have to make is fine tuning or standard tuning. All AutoHarps have the tuning pegs along the top. These tuning pegs are used for your primary tuning. On an AutoHarp that does not have fine tuning, this will be the only way you're going to tune your AutoHarp. On a harp with fine tuning, you will make your primary adjustments up top and your secondary adjustments at the bottom to get the tone exact. Using an Allen wrench, you'll make slight turns on the bottom. Each revolution of this pin makes a much smaller degree of difference than a revolution of this pin. One other feature of fine tuning is, over time, these pegs, since they just go into wood, can loosen. This isn't something that's going to happen very soon or very often. It's only for the players that play all the time and tune very frequently. When you have fine tuning at the bottom, it does take some of the back and forth out of trying to achieve the perfect sound. One key note, however, you do still want to do most of your tuning at the top. The tuning at the bottom is limited, as this screw can reach its bottom limits. This peg at the top can be turned many more times than this peg can at the bottom. To summarize, there's five basic choices you have to make when choosing an AutoHarp: 21 chord or 15 chord, acoustic, electric, or electric, the type of wood, mostly for aesthetic reasons, the finish, and the type of tuning. Now that I've discussed the five factors that come into play when deciding on an AutoHarp, I'm going to discuss a couple of customer questions that we get that people are thinking are factors in AutoHarps, but really don't play much of a role in your decision making. One of which is weight. We have customers that are performing and they have to hold the AutoHarp, or they're getting older in life and they don't want something as heavy to lug around, so they want the lightest AutoHarp possible. However, unfortunately, most of the AutoHarps have almost the same weight. The difference is in ounces. The reason for this is, despite the different woods, the mahogany or the maple or the spruce, that is just a veneer on the outside. It makes very little difference. The inside, block rock maple for the pin base and standard maple for the rest of the frame, is the same in every AutoHarp, and the construction is about the same in every AutoHarp. The componentry, the number of strings, all these things add up to approximately the same weight, so this is not going to be a deciding factor in which AutoHarp you're going to buy. Another question we get quite often is, the customer knows that they want a 21 chord or they know they want a 15 chord, but they ask, which one is the easiest to play for a beginner? There really is no easier to play. The chord layout is exactly the same on every one of the 21 chord AutoHarps and exactly the same on any of the 15 chord AutoHarps. The string layout is exactly the same. So once you pick 15 or 21 chord, the decision of which one is easier to play out of all the selections is negligible. It doesn't have one that is easier to play than the other one. So I'm glad I was able to help you pick out an AutoHarp. Our AutoHarpStore.com representatives are here 6 days a week, 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. Eastern. We also have all the accessories you might need, from cases to books to strings and other replacement parts. We have everything you need to maintain your AutoHarp, play your AutoHarp, and enjoy your AutoHarp for years to come. Thank you.